At St. Paul, we're number one. In Canada, we're number 83. And who knows what place the Leafs are in. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. When I said that we at St. Paul are number one, I'm not exaggerating in the least bit. Here at St. Paul, everything we do with heart. And last Friday before Thanksgiving, you should have seen the food that was collected and assembled. You know, little St. Paul, the smallest high school in the school board, has the biggest heart. We filled the school van full of canned food and non-perishable food. We took care of some very needy people in our local community, and then with Miss Hastings and her religion class, we brought all the food over to Dr. Simone's. And you should have seen the smile on Dr. Simone's face as the girls in Miss Hastings' class unloaded our school van. It took 15 minutes to take the food out. What an awesome sight. Thank you. The poor won't have an opportunity to thank you, but be assured that one day in heaven, you will be thanked for remembering, as so many of you did, to bring in food, toothpaste, all kinds of great items. We are indeed number one. In Canada, we're number 83, however. What am I talking about? I'm talking about voter turnout. It seems that among democratic countries in the world, Canada is 83rd when it comes to people actually going out to vote on elections. Now, elections for prime minister, federal elections, such as today, just a little over 60% of registered voters actually turn up to vote in elections. That number falls in municipal elections, where fewer than 30% of voters go out to vote. Let me encourage you today, if you are eligible to vote, to please get out there and do so. Maybe you can babysit for your parents and give them a chance to vote. Babysit for a neighbor. Speak to your neighbor, ask them, remind them that today is election day. You know, some very important issues are being decided. Issues on the future of Canada in Afghanistan, climate change, the economy, huge issues. Let's get out and vote, and above all, make an educated voting decision. Now, I need your help. It was brought to my attention that a young boy in our community needs your help. This young boy, a grade one student at St. Timothy's School, was diagnosed Friday morning with an extremely rare and dangerous form of leukemia. Already, after being admitted just on Friday, this young boy has undergone 5 very stringent chemotherapy sessions. The boy is going to be in hospital for at least 10 months. Grade one student, let's pray for him. His name is Anthony. Let's keep him in our prayers. And all of the people in our community that need prayers today, on this day after Thanksgiving, we pray, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. St. Paul, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Good morning, St. Paul. My name is Shereen DeSantos, and here is today's news. Kids Health Phone is looking for student ambassadors. Training will be provided Saturday, November 15th or Sunday, November 16th at Metro Hall in Toronto. Students who are interested can get more information and pick up an application from Ms. Lothian in Student Services. Students are reminded that full winter uniform is now in effect, and photo retakes are today. You may get a retake if you're away on photo day, or your picture did not turn out, or the barcode on your ID did not show up. Students will be called in alphabetical order. If you are having a retake done, you must bring in your student ID with you. If you are away from school on photo day, you do not. The student council meeting is rescheduled for today. It will be moved to Wednesday, October 15th in room 234 at 2:30 p.m. Talent night audition will be held in the music room this Thursday and Friday only. Please be sure to sign up on the poster in the CAF. On behalf of the Act Now Committee, we would like to thank the St. Paul community for their generosity and contributions to this year's Thanksgiving food drive. We were able to help Dr. Simone's warehouse as well as the needy in our community. We are also grateful to all the students who gave up their time to collect, sort, and load the bus and take the food over to the warehouse. We are so impressed at how such a small school always goes above and beyond when needed. The homerooms that brought in the most items per student are as follows: Ms. Hastings, grade 9, Mr. Powers, grade 10, Ms. Bono, grade 11, and Ms. DeMarco, grade 12, and our outstanding students in PIP. Special recognition goes out to Ms. DiCarlo, Ms. Charnetska, and Ms. Schlarp, but again, a huge overall thank you to all the members of the community. Kirk Panetta, David Patch, Emily Porfido, and Nicole Daly are to meet in the CAF with Jillian after school today. Dance, dance, dance. St. Paul, do you want to get your groove on? Then come out to the annual St. Paul Fall Ball Dance on October 24th from 7:30 to 11 p.m. Tickets will be on sale starting today for $10 each. There will be great music and tons of prizes, like movie passes and CDs, so don't miss out on this chance to dance the night away. Tickets will be sold during 3A and 3C lunches starting Tuesday for $10. SPAC is planning another hike to Bruce Trail. What is the Bruce Trail, you ask? The Bruce Trail is a beautiful hiking trail located in southern and central Ontario. It follows the edge of the Niagara Escarpment for more than 800 kilometers. Just ask any of the grade 9s and 10s that have just completed their 10-kilometer hike, and they will tell you just how lucky we are to have such an amazing ecosystem in our own province. Come and get a taste of the trail on November 1st when SPAC Outdoor Club takes a hike to Crawford Lake. Sign up now in the cafeteria as space is limited to one busload. That's all the news for today, St. Paul. The song of the day is I Want to Ride My Bicycle by Queen, and have a great day.
Bicycle, bicycle, bicycle. I want to ride.